kindly said by Mahatma Gandhi, the greatness of humanity is not in the human, but in the humane. We now request the Academy Coordinator, Mrs. Saputla Singh Ma'am, to announce the names of the students who have received the prestigious Dr. Sadhya Paul Award this year. We also request Ma'am to declare the result of the ADSE scholarship.
A very good morning to respected Principal Mr. P. Subhash, Vice Principal Mrs. Preeti Gupta, Primary Coordinator Mrs. K. C. Vijayalakshmi, teachers, and my dear students. APK Education, in its commitment and endeavor in pursuit of excellence, encourages the students and awards various scholarships every year. It gives me immense pleasure to announce the results and felicitate the winners of the two prestigious awards on this auspicious occasion of Founders Day. Today, we are going to felicitate the winners of Dr. Sadhya Paul Award for Human Values and students who have won APK Talent Search Scholarship 2023. Dr. Sadhya Paul Award for Human Values is given every year to minimum 3 students who exhibit a deep sense of human values and high level of integrity in his or her behavior and conduct. The winners from each middle, secondary and senior secondary group are awarded with a certificate of honor and check of rupees 5,000, 7,500 and 10,000 respectively. May I request our respected Principal Mr. P. Subhash and our Vice Principal Ma'am Ms. Vinti Gupta to kindly come on the stage and do the honor please. I also request the head boy and the head girl to escort them. Amit Jokar Anand from 10C. She was the president of the Cool Insurance Club last year. She contributed her best as a member of the Insurance Club from class 6 to class 9. Let's give a big round of applause to Amit Gurkar Ani. From the senior section, we have a very dynamic, a great singer, a good orator. He is also the senior captain of Nalanda House. Yes, you all guessed it right. It is none other than Supranil Chaturaj from 12C. Welcome Supranil with a big round of applause. Move on to the ACSE Fellowship. We have chosen 10 of our students have shown their excellence in academics by qualifying ACSE Talent Scholarship Examination 2023. He has added another feather to his cap by scoring third position among 13 schools. Let's have Abhay from the school. Students clap loudly for Abhay's telepathy.
Thank you.
tenth age. That the fellowship by getting the 12th position among the 13 schools, great achievement. Ishan is heading towards the stage to receive the prize. And now, we move on to class 11. Here two students receive the scholarship. One is Nan Abedan, our school topper in AISSE examination. By scoring 99%, she was a school topper. Yes, children, it is Janvi Patel from 11B. She placed 8 amongst all the 13 schools. Can we hear it loudly for Janvi Patel? Another student from class 11 is Shlok Sanju from 11th A. He scored 18th position overall. Let's welcome Shlok on the stage with a thunderous round of applause. And last but not the least, the only student who qualified from class 12 is none other than another all-rounder, most deserving, Rohan Yadav from 12B. Rohan stands 9th position overall. Audience, he deserves a big round of applause. Thank you, sir, and thank you, ma'am. With this, we come to the end of the felicitation. Dear children, keep soaring higher and bring more glory to your school and to yourselves. On behalf of ATK School Nehru, I once again congratulate all the winners. Our best wishes and God bless you all. Thank you. I now hand over the mic to the top team.
Thank you, ma'am, and congratulations to all the winners. You truly inspire us. Dr. Satyapal's legacy of excellence is being carried forward by his only child, Madam Sushma Paul Berlia, Chairman of the ABJ Education Society. Madam Berlia has made an outstanding contribution in ensuring that the ABJ vision of quality education of global standards leading to man-making and nation-building is effectively reflected in the conceptualization and standardization of the academic programs and curricula across all its 24 institutions. I now request our respected principal, Mr. P. Subhash sir, to address the gathering and read out the message of our honorable chairperson, Madam Sushma Berlia.
Was also a great freedom fighter, a philanthropist, a social very early in life. They were soldiers with lots of love and affection, and from then onwards, he developed the trait of putting others before himself. He was, if anything, a living example of modesty and humility, and preferred to let his words speak for him. He had valuable qualities of hard work, fearlessness, and love for truth, and these stood him in good stead as he pioneered the APJ Satyagraha into an industrial conglomerate and the APJ Education Society, which is a social commitment of the group, into one of the most respected and successful educational organizations of India. Under him, 24 APJ institutions, schools, colleges, and higher institutes have come up and flowered to become a symbol of excellence in their various disciplines, molding the life and careers of all future generations. Year 2020 also saw the realization of his dream of setting up the APJ Satya University, a world-class university that would not only be a seat of global learning, but also one that brings about transformation of society through value-based, man-making, the nation-building education. Once I had asked him as to how from humble beginnings he had been able to turn APJ Satya into one of the biggest success stories of the nation, he had replied that he had only concentrated on working hard with dedication and commitment, as he believed that work is worship. He said that along the way, he met talented and committed people who joined him in this quest of excellence, and good things kept happening. Over the years, he has been actively associated with several causes in the field of industry, education, and social uplift. Kind, benevolent, and ever ready to help all, he left a lasting impact on all those who came into contact with him. All this was done quietly. He never took any credit, only liked to pass it around. He deserved no monument or awards for himself, though over the years, innumerable awards and honors have been conferred on him by governments, universities, and organizations for his contribution to the development of nature in both education and industry. Dr. Satyapal was always a positive thinker who faced all the problems with a smiling countenance, never say dry attitude, and an unflinching faith in the Almighty. Though he was a hard taskmaster, his punctuality, sense of discipline, dedication, and focus made him an ideal role model of excellence for all those who worked with him. For him, work was passion, and he hated to miss office even when he was ill. He had a sharp memory of people, was an excellent listener, apart from being a good orator and writer. He was a lover of Urdu poetry and had a deep interest in spiritualism, philosophy, culture, and arts. He had a keen insight into events and people, and loved the company of children. He always remembered those who helped him, and was a friend of friends. He had kind words for even those who opposed him. Once many years ago, Swami Rekhoyananda of the Ramakrishna Mission said three words to him: be a man. By this, my father told me, changed the entire perspective of his life. Today, I would like to tell everyone that this is what he had always been in life, and deed of a man, in the true sense of the word, a purushottam. So, as we remember and honor him on his 104th birth anniversary, let us celebrate both what our founder chairman, Dr. Satyapal, was, what he stood for. Let us take efforts to uphold the legacy of excellence that he leaves behind and strive to achieve the goals to which he devoted life. I would like to end with one of the favorite Urdu couplets of my father, the inspiration behind his life and the motto of APJ Education Society, soaring high is my nature. You are a falcon, soaring high is your nature. There are skies yet for you to conquer. Thank you. After these words, our honorable Madam Kishamapur Bandiya has sent to you with a lot of love and concern. And my appeal to you all, my dear teachers and dear kids and my children, always make the school proud. Because there were people work behind us, such a great person, his legacy, his dreams, made lakhs and lakhs of Indians' life colorful. And you are also one of the beneficiaries of that dream. So you got a chance, grow as good citizens of India, keep good values with you, always be ready to help others, always fight problems of others, and always you should have concern for others, and you should be a front of fronts. And you will be definitely a successful person in your life, how our foreign frontier person has achieved his life. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for doing the honor. We are also grateful to Madam Bandiya for this inspirational message. Exuberant, lively, and full of zeal are a few words that describe our beloved founder, Dr. Satyapalji. Over the decades, he has motivated millions of youngsters, equipped them with high-quality education, moral values, staunch belief in God, a positive attitude, and an ambition to go out and make a difference in the world. Moving on, we have a tiny tot from pre-primary to dance a patriotic number. This beautiful song, Lehrabo, expresses the process of achieving success after several failures, and it teaches us to never give up.
you for the graceful performance. Indian Education Society prides itself in instilling right values among the students and molds them to become responsible citizens. This starts from the classrooms itself. I now call our student representative, the head girl, Tara Jahangir, to re-inspire us with the values and motto of always soaring high. But it is if we have no dreams to dream. Today, as we gather to celebrate Founders Day, we come together not just to commemorate the visionary who laid the foundation of this great institution, but to honor the enduring spirit of innovation, knowledge, and community that continues to thrive within these hallowed walls. Dr. Satyapal, eminent industrialist and educationist, provided the foundation and inspiration for the emergence of the APJ Satyagraha and the APJ Education Society as trusted symbols of quality and excellence in the country's industrial and educational landscape. Our founder, whose name we proudly invoke today, was the builder of dreams, champion of education and advocate of progress. Starting with a small school in Jalandhar in 1967, 13 schools and 16 institutions with higher learning established by him over the last four decades under the aegis of the APJ Education Society have flowered to become symbols of excellence in their various disciplines, molding the lives and careers of the future generations of the country. His unwavering commitment to knowledge and betterment of society ignited the spark that still burns brightly within each of us. As we reflect upon our past, we're reminded of the sacrifices made, challenges overcome, and triumphs celebrated. In this rapidly changing world, with the boundaries of knowledge expand with every passing day, it's crucial that we remain faithful to the ideals of our founders. We must be relentless in our pursuit of knowledge, fearless in the face of adversity, and compassionate in our interaction with one another. Founders Day is not just about celebrating the past, it's about embracing the future. It's about fostering an environment where Dr. Satyapal Ji's dreams can flourish, where the pursuit of excellence is a daily endeavor, where diversity of thought and background is cherished as a source of strength. In conclusion, 4th October is not just a special day for us, it's a state of mind. It's a reminder that part of the shape our destiny lies within each of us. Let us celebrate this day with gratitude for our past and optimism for our future. Together, we can continue to build upon our dreams of our founders and create a brighter and enlightened world for all of us. Thank you, and may our founders' legacy inspire us all.
Thank you, Zara, for reviving the spirit of hard work and excellence in us by describing the legacy of a beloved founder. Dr. Satyapal, eminent industrialist, educationist, philanthropist, and freedom fighter, provided the foundation and inspiration for the emergence of the APJ Satyagraha Group and the APJ Education Society as trusted symbols of quality and excellence in India's industrial and educational landscape. Now, we would like to invite our respected Vice Principal, Ms. P.P. Gupta Ma'am, to take us through the inspirational life history of Dr. Satyapal. Good morning, everyone. Today is a special day. And during the floral tribute, I just wondered to myself,
does it take to make an impact such great that lasts long after you are gone? And I understood it is the commitment of a person, the passion, the integrity, which make a person bigger than the life itself. Founders Day at APJ Nehru provides us with an opportunity to consider the legacy which has shaped our school. Our founder, Dr. Satyapal ji, was such a man who overcame innumerable odds, physical and otherwise, throughout his life. And this year, on October 4, 2023, we celebrate the 104th birth anniversary of Dr. Satyapal ji. Our roots go back to over 50 years. The APJ Education Society, which has built a rich heritage of quality education through a family of 24 non-profit educational institutions, including the APJ Satya University, has its foundation stone laid 5 decades ago in Jalandhar, Punjab, on 4th December 1967. I know we all want to be big one day, very big, successful, happy. But these stories, these live examples, they motivate us. A pioneering entrepreneur with a far-sighted vision of the future, late Dr. Satyapal ji, an eminent industrialist, educationist, philanthropist and a freedom fighter, was instrumental in the rise of the APJ Group as one of the biggest industrial houses of independent India, and was a leading architect of country's emergence as a self-reliant industrial superpower, founded on the strength of Indian capability and enterprise. He fulfilled his dream to establish world-class educational institutions, the institutions that would mold and guide future generations with an enlightened mind. The institution speaks volumes of his great vision, ethics, human values, philosophy and untiring efforts, and have been instrumental in carrying forward the shared vision of man-making and nation-building education of global standards of its founder chairman, Dr. Satyapal ji. Today, I really want you to know more about Dr. Satyapal ji. His great leadership and missionary zeal gave APJ Satya Group a place of distinction among the top education societies, foundations of the country. Dr. Satyapal ji, founder chairman of the APJ Satya Group, suffered physical handicap caused by polio at the age of 2. He overcame his disability and humble beginnings to become one of the most respected men in this nation. Born in 1919, Satyapal ji moved with his family to Lahore, now in Pakistan. When he was a child, he joined relatives who had set up a small workshop to manufacture steel items. The families later moved to Jalandhar, which is in Punjab, to start a small factory. The business started prospering, and by mid-1930s, they had expanded the product line to include several steel items. By the onset of Second World War, it goes back to that time, they were well established in the business and had employed about 100 people in their factory. The
even though he had to study by the lantern light. At night, as the family could not afford electricity, can you just imagine? He performed well enough on his matriculation exam to win a merit scholarship to DAV College, Jalandhar, where he displayed extraordinary talent in mathematics, securing first position in BA honors in the subject as well as a gold medal. He became a university record holder for several years in the state of Punjab. This led him to enroll in a mathematics course in Government College in Lahore, where he placed third in the university's final MA exam in 1941. And it is considered that the level of education at that time was even higher and difficult as compared to today. He also played an active role in the country's freedom struggle and even went to jail. When his father passed away in 1944, Satyapal ji took on the dual responsibilities of running the family business and overseeing the education of his siblings, including the higher studies of two of his brothers in the United States. He, along with his brothers, developed his father's small business into one of the biggest industrial houses in the country, diversifying into shipping, pharma, construction, hotels, trading, tea gardens, etc. After completing his post-graduation, Satyapal ji had sought a lectureship in a college in Punjab, but was rejected because of his physical handicap. However, his passion for education remained undiminished, and he was deeply concerned about the lack of quality education or quality schools in post-independent India. We're not talking about today. We're just talking about the time we got independent. This prompted him to launch the APJ Education Society in 1967 with a small school in Jalandhar, which is now a very, very big school. Today, the society runs 13 schools and 13 institutes of higher learning spread over 25 campuses with more than 32,000 on roll. And many more schools are to be added to this number. All the APJ institutes are guided by the Dr. Satyapal ji's vision of value-based holistic education, focusing on acquiring thinking skills and learning how to learn for life. His vision of excellence in education is truly global, transcending the confines of state and country. Dr. Satyapal ji, by virtue of his strong willpower, caliber, strong dedication and leadership qualities, has occupied a pivotal position in the academic community. He served as president of the Engineering Association of India, the Federation of Engineering Industries of India, and the Northern India Chamber of Commerce. He also played key roles in the Rotary Clubs in Jalandhar, Delhi Midtown, and District 301, and served for several years as chairman of the Handicap Committee of the Rotary Club of Delhi Midtown. Throughout his life, he helped hundreds of needy people secure jobs and scholarships. Throughout his life, he helped hundreds of them with so many things that they cannot be even counted. The college that had turned up down for a lectureship early in his career, they had literally turned him down because of his physical handicap, later elected him the president of its governing body. The Thames Valley Institute, London, awarded Dr. Satyapal ji a PhD for his valuable contribution in the field of education. His love of Urdu poetry, spiritualism, philosophy, mysticism, music and art is very well reflected in his book, Reflections in Time. He also published a quarterly family magazine called Chang Calling, Bikhre Phool. His second book is also a masterpiece. He was
the true Karam Yogi, who valued integrity and selflessness above all. The legacy left by him has proved that it is possible to fulfill your dreams with your values serving as a compass. He is an inspiration to generations who dream to succeed. He believed it is not a disgrace if dreams are unfulfilled. I repeat, it is not a disgrace if dreams are unfulfilled, but it is if we have no dreams to dream. And remember that, children, you continue to dream. You might achieve only half of it. That's okay. He said, that's okay. But if you will stop dreaming, that will ruin everything. We believe, as our founder did, that the cultivation of virtue will perfect our intellectual life. And on that note, let's all wish Dr. Satya Paulji a very happy birthday. Thank you so much. For enriching us with the glimpses of great Dr. Satya Paulji's life. Perseverance is not a long way. It is many short phases, one after the other. Dr. Satya Paulji has always believed in hard work and relentless effort. His life exemplifies perseverance and endurance, and he stood as the epitome of determination. Dr. Satya Paulji inspires us to work hard consistently and persevere until our goal is met. Hard work never goes in vain. To portray the same, we have the students from the primary and middle section to perform a dance drama on the theme, Dr. Satya Paul, a true Karma Yogi. This performance combines the elements of invocation dance with the instrumental music, a birthday song, which will take you on a captivating journey through the world of Dr. Satya Paul, and will also portray the theme of women empowerment. Finally, you will see a performance with a blend of mime, contemporary and Indian contemporary classical dance. So without further ado, let's all welcome them for a power-packed performance.
Good.
The patriotic fervor of the Indian nationalists and freedom fighters urged them to participate in large numbers in the Great India Open against the British.
जो तुझसे लिख की बेड़ियां सम समझना इनको वस्त्र तू, ये बेड़ियां निकाल के बना ले इनको शस्त्र तू, बना ले इनको शस्त्र तू, तो खुद की खोज में निकल, तो किस लिए हताश है, तो चल तेरे वजूद की समय को भी तलाश है, समय को भी तलाश है, चरित्र जब पवित्र है तो क्यों नहीं है दशा तेरी, चरित्र जब पवित्र है तो क्यों नहीं है दशा तेरी, ये पापियों को हक नहीं कि नहीं परीक्षा तेरी, कि नहीं परीक्षा तेरी, तो खुद की खोज में निकल, तो किस लिए हताश है, तो जल तेरे वजूद की समय को भी तलाश है, जला के भस्म कर उसे जो क्रूरता का जाल है, जला के भस्म कर उसे जो क्रूरता का जाल है, तू आरती की लौ नहीं तू क्रोध की मशाल है, तू क्रोध की मशाल है, तो खुद की खोज में निकल, किस लिए बताश है, तो चल तेरे वजूद की समय को भी तलाश है, समय को भी तलाश है, शुगर को आके ध्वज बना गगन भी कप कपाएगा, चुनर उड़ा के ध्वज बना गगन भी कप कप आएगा, अगर तेरी चुनर गई तो एक भूकंप आएगा, एक भूकंप आएगा, तो खुद की खोज में निकल, तो किस लिए हताश है, तो चल तेरे वजूद की समय को भी तलाश है, समय को भी तलाश है। Thank you.
Continue to shape the future of countless students, including you and I.
I would like to thank Dr. Satya Paul G's beloved daughter and our president, Madam Pushpa Paul Goyal, for a heartfelt message. Thank you so much, Principal Sir, Mr. P. Subhash, for always being the guiding light of the school. A big thank you to our Vice Principal, Madam Mrs. C.T. Gupta, for being the backbone in the organizing of this event. My heartfelt gratitude to respected academic coordinator, Mrs. Shankla Singh, ma'am, pre-primary coordinator, Mrs. Benalini Singh, ma'am, primary coordinator, Mrs. K.C. Vijayalakshmi, and all my teachers present here for gracing us with the office. I would be failing in my duty if I don't thank the people who made this event possible, which is why I extend my gratitude to the participants who put on countless hours of practice under the guidance of our dance teacher, Mr. Shreya Ma'am, and music teacher, Mr. Brij Kishore Sir, and the teacher in charge who made this celebration a grand one. I am grateful to the ancillary staff and also the prefect on duty who worked behind the curtain and made sure everything was in place. Last but not the least, thank you all for being an amazing audience throughout this marvelous celebration and also for patiently bearing through my speech. Without further ado, signing off, and may you have an amazing day ahead. Now, I request everyone to register for the national anthem.